here on the final day of alpine skiing competition. It's the men's slalom up in the Sierra Nevada mountains, and as you can see, conditions extremely difficult as the clouds and snow have come in and visibility is virtually nil. Temperature of -6. So temperature-wise, we're good, but as you can see, just really difficult conditions in terms of visibility for these athletes. But nonetheless, they are ready to go. First up, this is Maxime Rizzo of France. He finished third in the French Nationals in slalom back in December. And there you see the time to beat. And at the interval, he's well ahead, about a second and a half. Also won three FIS races in France leading up to Universiade in slalom. And there's his time, over a second and a half ahead. So he will move right now into first place. Next up is Filip Mlinsek of Slovenia. Again, the conditions are so difficult. The poles he has there glowing in this very dark, cloudy, snowy day in the mountains. Making his way very well down through these gates. Of course, this is a timed race between two different runs, so they will do this first one. Mlinsek not enough to beat Rizzo. He'll be just over half a second behind. So this first run will be added with their second run to give the total time, and then that will determine the winners. This is Ramon Zinhausern of Switzerland. He was sixth in the giant slalom 2 days ago and 22nd at a World Cup race at Kitzbühel in Austria back in January. He moves into first place here, 1.35 seconds ahead of Rizzo. Now we look at Matej Falat of Slovakia. He already has a bronze medal in these games from the Super Combined back earlier in competition. He's also 13th in the Super G, but did not finish in the giant slalom. Working his way quite well through these gates here. And his time, a little over 2 seconds behind that of Zinhausern. So he will be fourth after the first run. And there you take a look at the standings after the first run. Conditions now clearing up a little bit as we head into the second run. And here is Falat. He did compete in the slalom at the Sochi Olympics, but did not finish on his first run. This is his second Universiade. He was 9th in the slalom in Trentino, 29th in the downhill, and 24th in the Super G. At the interval, he is a little bit ahead of pace. As he works his way down through these gates, again, visibility much, much better now for these athletes. They have a better sense of where they're heading on this course. Robin Bouffet, the time to beat right now from France. And Falat, 3/4 of a second ahead, moves temporarily into first place. Now it's the Slovenian Mlinsek. He's a rarity in that this is actually his fourth Universiade. He won a silver medal in Erzurum in Turkey back in 2011. He was 12th in Harbin in 2009 in the slalom, and then 16th most recently in 2013 in Trentino. Working very well through these tight gates. And as he heads his way now down towards the finish line, the time to beat. And he's just behind. He'll move now into second place. 5/100s back, and you can see him there. He knows how close he was. Now Rizzo, second after the first run. The time of 49.24. So can he find a way to finish in first spot or get to first right now? Rizzo making his way quite well down through the gates. But there, you see him just slip up, and he will miss the gate, much to his frustration, and he is out of the competition. Now the leader after the first run, Zenhausern of Switzerland. He was 19th in the slalom at the Sochi Olympics. Well ahead at the interval of Fallat's time. So if he can make sure to stay upright and get through all the gates, he should be able to ski away with a gold medal. 96 competitors from 27 countries in this competition, and Zenhausern is looking to be the best of the bunch, and he is. An outstanding time, 3.68 seconds ahead of Matej Fallat of Slovakia. Zenhausern crushes the field today. And there you take a look at the standings. Zenhausern will take gold. Fallat of Slovakia, the silver. And Filip Linsek of Slovenia will claim the bronze medal here in the men's slalom at the Sierra Nevada Mountains.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.